I'm just going to talk a little bit about some of the ways that people celebrate Easter, but not in the religious sense. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we have the Easter Bunny.
Yep.
Which is Easter's version of Santa Claus. I don't know the origins of the Easter Bunny. Mm-hmm. But what happens is, on the day before Easter, children go to sleep, and the Easter Bunny mm-hmm. visits and hides all of the eggs, and we'll talk about the eggs in a minute, hides all of the eggs, and then goes away, and then when the children wake up, they have Easter baskets mm-hmm. full of candy, and sometimes mm-hmm. full of candy and surprises, like candy and presents.
Yay.
Now, we don't typically get as many presents for Easter as we do at Christmas. Mm-hmm. At least in my family growing up, we maybe got some small toys. Mm-hmm. Anything that would fit in a basket.
Aww.
So you have your basket, and then inside the basket you have this plastic grass. Mm-hmm. And that's where, like, in the basket, on top of the grass, you have your chocolate bunny. Mm-hmm. And those were always fun. So you can have a solid chocolate bunny. Mm-hmm. Or you can have a hollow chocolate bunny.
Hollow.
Hollow. H-O-L-L-O-W. That means hollow. It's a chocolate form, but inside is air. It's hollow. And so a solid one is you bite into it and there's chocolate. It's solid. Okay, a hollow one is you bite into it and, like, you take off the bunny ears. Uh-huh. And then inside it's air. It's just the shell of it's a shell of a candy. Shell of a chocolate bunny. Uh-huh. We used to always have jelly beans also.
Oh.
Yeah. Jelly beans and chocolate bunnies. Oh my, you disappeared. Oh no.